how to succeed in math courses. Be aware of the differences between math courses in high school and university level courses. While a course such as calculus may follow the same syllabus as a high school math course, the depth of the materials covered, the level of detail required, and sometimes the method of answering a question might be different in the university level math course. Additionally, you are also expected to be more independent in your investigations of the course material. Be aware of such disparities and strive to bring your performance and mastery level to that required for a university level course. Cautiously use external resources. It may be possible for you to find an explanation or a solution for a problem on a given website. However, the assumptions of base knowledge might be substantially different from those in your course. Meanwhile, consulting different sources carelessly increases the risk of academic misconduct. After all, your work should reflect your understanding of the topic. Do use the Math Help Center. The Department of Mathematics offers in-person and online help to the first-year math students. This help is one-on-one, and no appointments are necessary. The Math Help Center is operated by our graduate student teaching assistants in the Math Physics Accelerator, located at the Physics and Astronomy Building. More detail can be found on the Math Department's main page. Being able to follow a solution is not enough. Being able to follow a solution written by someone else, your professor, for example, is only an early stage of learning a topic. You should have the ability to generate such solutions by yourself. Bicycling is the only way to learn how to ride one. You cannot learn how to ride a bike by sitting and watching others do it. And the same is true for mathematics. It is essential that you follow this approach, especially when using the Student Solutions Manual for your textbook. Practicing how to write math properly is the key. An answer to a mathematics problem, beyond being mathematically sound, must also be written in a mathematically logical and sensible manner. Math is a language, and a piece of writing in it, just like any other language, must adhere to its syntactic rules and grammar. To be able to write an effective math piece, one must know the meaning of the characters and symbols required, the definitions of the related words and concepts, and use them all in the proper context and manner. Throughout the textbook, lecture notes, and videos, there are examples and problems that are solved not only to teach you the content, but also to show you how the math is to be written. Practice in asking a friend or a member of the course staff to read your solution is a great way to improve your writing. Treat your solutions as a story and try to include as much detail as possible. Don't be afraid to write a few words beside the formulas as well to help your marker see what tools, theorems, or facts you are using in each step. After all, you won't be there when your work is graded, so the explanations you provide in your work will have to stand on their own. The more you practice, the better you'll get. Don't be afraid of failure. Try as many times as necessary. Like any sport or artistic endeavor, we learn mathematics by doing mathematics. At first, we usually make many mistakes, and we may stare at problems for hours without even knowing how to start. Remember that, initially, the number of attempts should not matter. Try different ideas, draw pictures, look at examples, solve a simpler version of the same problem, speak to your friends, or go back to the textbook. You must not give up.